To the fire exits. And there are two at the back of the hall, the doors through which you came, if you paid, and there's one over here on my left and your right. Secondly, there should be no new reason to use these exits whatsoever, because smoking is forbidden within the confines of the hall. Secondly, there will be a raffle at the interval in aid of the School Development Fund, and I ask that you contribute. You can purchase 6 tickets for £1, and also there are £5 tickets which you can purchase, which makes you eligible for a World Cup draw, and if you purchase one of those, you get another one of the other ones free. Well, you make sense of that better than I am. Anyway, finally, within 20 minutes of the end of the show, the school gates will be closed, and all cars left behind will be impounded. So, you better take your cars with you, because I'm on the lookout for a nice Porsche Turbo. Okay, what are we doing then? Jones? Jones it is then! Are you ready then?
No!
Good. Time for a joke. Did you hear the one about German Admiral Graf von and his three daughters, Nit von, Pearl von, and Plain von? Oh. Didn't think you had. Shall I tell you another one then? There were these two generals who went down to Frinton, paddling happily away in the water, when one general turns to the other one and says, "Good God, Redhead, your feet are filthy."
"Damn it all, men,"
said the other general.
"I wasn't here last year."
"You see, you couldn't get the stone." "All right, never mind. Are you ready back there now?"
"Yes."
"Good. My lords, ladies and gentlemen, may we present for you the ever popular war game."
Of working democracy the world has ever seen.
Here, absolutely here.
And the lady on my left.
The seat of reason, the center of world civilization, culture, and l'amour.
God, come on, stop it, come on, a lot of you. They're not doing that, they're eating. How big is your acreage then?
6 million square kilometers.
And you, my hell?
Germany, a mere 3 million square kilometers. But we are a new nation, united only since 1871.
When you stole our capital rights, ours, Germany!
Hey, we haven't started to play the game yet.
We are a disciplined, moral, industrious people. We want more say in the world's affairs.
I'll have to keep an eye on you. Hey, let's have the Russian anthem there, Carl.
Germany shall win this battle by an envelopment with the right wing.
Violates neutrality of Belgium and the Netherlands?
Well, it's far down for. The year is 12 days after mobilization. Brussels 2 days later. We shall enter Paris at 11:30 precisely on the 10th day.
And the Russians?
Ha, they won't be ready till 1916.
Time's up!
France admits no law with the offensive. Advance with all their forces to attack the German army. France, her bugle sounding, her soldiers armed for glory, her will to conquer, an idea and a sword.
Besides, they will attack Russia first.
The Russian steamroller. We have 1.5 million bayonets spared to death bullets any day. Once in motion, we go rolling forward, didn't
we? Inexorably. Hey, the bar's open. Go get yourself a drink. Hang about. You got snow on your boots, Ivan. Well done.
In the event of a war, the Royal Navy will keep more than 1 million Germans busy. We shall disembark on a 10-mile strip of hard sand in the northern shores of Prussia and draw off more than our weight of numbers from the fighting line. The overwhelming supremacy of the Royal Navy is the only thing to keep the Germans out of Paris.
Here.
But on a point of order, sir, your plans appear to have very little in common with those of the army.
Look here. You soldiers are a pretty grotesque lot with your absurd ideas about war. Happily, you are powerless. We could go right ahead and leave you fooling around in the bushes. Have you even got a plan?
Of course.
Ha! Yes, I thought so.
Any questions so far? Got all the plans off then? Good. Hey, let's have a schmaltzy with Erica. Find the anarchist. I can't help you anymore on this one because I play a statue.
Cruising down the river on a Sunday afternoon.
Did you hear that?
What? You mean that shot?
Yeah.
Oh, no. I heard nothing.
I'll have a beer, please.
The lovely weather we're having all the same.
Yeah.
Very good. Did you say somebody shot somebody?
Yeah. The Archduke Ferdinand.
The big one.
The way.
No. Who did he shoot?
No, he was shot.
Oh, I see. Did they know who did it?
That's the question. He's driving in one of them cars.
Gee, them cars is fierce, dangerous altogether.
Yeah. With the Archduchess.
Oh, big, fat, fluffy.
Yeah, big, fat, fluffy. With the revolver.
Should have used a pistol. A Browning automatic.
With a Browning automatic, you can shoot 10 Archdukes and 10 Archduchesses. Do you know who did it?
Oh, no.
Do you?
No, I never mentioned politics.
So what have you done with the picture of the Archduke Ferdinand?
I had to take down flies on the business on it.
Oh, I'll tell you exactly who did it.
Sure, it was either a Catholic, or a Protestant, or a Jew, or a Serb, or a Croat, or a young Czech liberal, or a syndicalist, or maybe even an anarchist. In any case, it means war.
You think so?
Of course. Bang, says Austria. Shoot my nephew, would you? There's one of the smackers for you.
Then in comes Kaiser Willy to help Austria. In comes Russia to help Serbia. Then comes France because they've hated the Germans since 1871.
Because they hated the Germans since 1871. Very good. Would you mind signing this, please?
Not at all. This war has been coming for a long time.
I'm glad you think so. Step out onto the pavement. I am a member of the Austro-Hungarian secret police.
And I am a member of the Serbian secret police.
We liquidated you yesterday. I arrest you for high treason.
Never mind, babe. What about her?
Good idea, we'll arrest you.
But I said nothing.
You said the flies could shyster on the Kaiser.
Left right, left right. This means war.
I understand that we have ordered Russia to demobilize us in 12 hours. The point is, will France remain neutral?
Russia is asking for time.
Where did you hear that?
It's all over town.
War is off then?
Yes, war is off.
Good.
Otto,
why not?
Ich bestelle hiermit das deutsche Volk und die kaiserliche Marine. Sind nach Mobilmachungsplan für das deutsche Volk und die kaiserliche Marine kriegsbereit aufzustellen. Weil der DA nicht versteht, werde ich euch einen kleinen Witz erzählen. Zicken, Tacken, Hühnerkacke. Im Übrigen ist der 1. August 1914 der erste Mobilmachungstag. Wilhelm, König von Preußen und deutscher Kaiser, Bethmann Hohlweg.
Cancelled.
Until further notice, there will be no more passenger trains leaving this station.
Until further notice, there will be no more passenger trains leaving this station.
The valve are being gulped in the most terrible of wars, the ultimate aim of which is the ruin of Germany. England, France, and Russia conspire together for our annihilation.
France is mobilized, Your Majesty.
As the encirclement of Germany is an accomplished fact. We have run our heads into a noose. What about England?
Oh, they have made up their minds.
They abandoned the plan.
It's too late, the wheels are already in motion.
Send a telegram to my cousin George V, notifying him my troops are being prevented by telephone and telegram from passing through Belgium.
All my first from a clump of trees, a meeting of two patrols, a black look, a brutal word, a shot. The maps are going out all over Europe. We shall not see them lit again in our lifetime.
There, they've gone into Luxembourg.
Notify England, France, Belgium. A platoon of Germans has entered Luxembourg.
Notify Lieutenant Feldman that he is to withdraw immediately from Luxembourg.
No, it's a mistake.
Advance into Luxembourg.
Advance?
Platoon withdraw.
Yeah, they've gone in all right. We're off.
The lady in the interpreter kindly remove the glass eye because it's distracting the cast. Thank you very much.
To play your part in war, and no matter what befalls you, we shall love you all the more. So come and join the forces as your fathers did before.
We want you and miss you, but we don't want to.
building, the Turkey Trust.
When Belgium was the Kaibosh on the Kaiser, the old took a singing song. And if Turkey makes a stand, she'll be Gurkhan and Japan, and it won't be up the Kaiser anymore.
We have to go to school again to learn its geography. We quite forgot Britannia and the hands across the sea. Australia and Canada, the Russian and the Jap. The shrinking was so small, he couldn't even see her on the map. What did Ireland think of that? After he had settled John. But he didn't know the Irish like he knew them later on. That the Kaiser was still alive. Please excuse him for the crime. But you see, his lunatic attendant wasn't with him.
At the time when Belgium put the Kaibosh on the Kaiser, Europe took a singing song.
Unbelievable. Heaps of corpses, French and German, lying everywhere. Thousands of dead are lying rows on top of each other. The guns recoil at each shot. Night is falling, and they look like old men, sticking out their tongues and spitting fire. The rain has started. Shells are bursting and screaming. Artillery fire was the worst. I lay all night listening to the wounded groaning. Whenever the cannonading stops, we hear the wounded groaning from all over the woods. Two or three men go mad every day.
Nothing more terrible could be imagined. We advance much too fast, and the men are desperately tired. I feel great pity for many of the civilians who have lost everything, but they hate us. One of them fired at us. He was immediately taken out and shot. Yesterday, we were ordered to attack the enemy flank in a forest of beeches, but the gunner saw us and opened fire. The men were done for. The shells fell like hail.
And now, then let your voices ring and all together sing on your heart. And now, not one battalion rules the waves, not lightly, while we have Jack upon the sea and Tommy on the